other people are doing. So, well, the X80 Pro. And yes, I know, the X90 Pro, it's launched globally in some areas, others not so much. And it's a weird situation with it. I don't know what is wrong and why Vivo isn't launching it in India. It's still just constantly getting postponed and it's screwing with my mind. And like, it's a bad situation. I get it. It's sad. I want to use the X90 Pro as much as anyone else. I want to test it out against all of these incredible other cameras that are just lying around here. But I can't. So we are going to stick with the X80 Pro for now. And see exactly how well I can perform against the Xiaomi 13 Pro. And I think it's going to be an interesting one. Even though there's a pretty massive generational gap between these two, I think the X80 is still going to be fairly surprising, especially when comparing to a next-gen device. So this right here, simple shot, but it's going to mark a key difference between the two. Now, you guys probably know if you've seen any of the camera comparisons I've made with the X80 Pro. Link to the playlist, by the way, is in the description. Now, I'm using the Zeiss Natural Colors here. It looks incredible. There is no other smartphone, at least amongst the ones that I've used, that has a natural color profile like the X80. The Xiaomi has something called Leica Authentic. I honestly thought this would be the new rival for the X80 Zeiss Natural Colors, but it's not quite there. Now, in a case like this, where there's a lot of even lighting, I mean, really does jack up the contrast. You can see it's almost starting to blow out the highlight in the sky, just barely. The thing is, if you really want natural colors in even lighting, you can try using Leica Authentic, but the dynamic range takes a massive hit. I compared the Xiaomi 13 Pro to the OnePlus 11, and in that comparison, I really showed off how the Leica Authentic can be detrimental for dynamic range. Check it out once again, link in the description. And well, let's move on to Leica Vibrant. Now here, as you can see, less contrast, far more detail in the shadows, and yes, a lot of vibrance. And my issue is not with the vibrance, you know, that's fine, that's personal preference. But the thing about the Xiaomi 13 Pro's Leica Vibrant is that the image gets cooled off a lot. And this happens in a lot of cases, you know, the natural warmth, it just doesn't get preserved all that much with Leica Vibrant. I wish I could use Leica Authentic, but the dynamic range takes a hit, so it's a weird situation, as I said. Now, in this case, it's a little bit more of a challenging shot. There's a bit of backlit situation, so needless to say, I'm using Leica Vibrant. And well, in this case, I'm not a big fan of the X80. It looks very, very flat. It's almost as if it's got a weird lens flare happening. While the Xiaomi, a lot of contrast, and it actually looks very nice here. But it doesn't just completely crush the shadows, and you still get a lot of details. Now, in this case, very backlit. As you can see, this is the afternoon sun that we're talking about here. And both phones are nailing the dynamic range. That is, you know, by far very impressive on both. And it's quite impressive for the X80. It's from last year and it's absolutely perfect here. But otherwise, we have the obvious differences. The X80 Pro, very natural colors. I mean, you can see the sky. It's pretty obvious that the Xiaomi really likes to make it vibrant. Now, here's an ultra wide shot, and as you can see, a simple shot, and both of them are basically perfect. Yes, the X80 Pro looks more natural. I mean, those greens look basically perfect. This is exactly how I remember seeing them when I took the shot. The Xiaomi, of course, a little bit more vibrant. Now, which one you want, that's gonna depend on you. I'm just gonna leave it up to you guys. But for a backlit ultra wide shot, well, now I actually prefer the Xiaomi far more because it just has a contrast. And I really like high contrast images. And let's face it, the X80 looks flat. It looks like the shadows are just lifted way too much. There's no real blacks in the entire shot, and it doesn't look very nice. Now here's another backlit ultra wide, and yeah, this time it's really close. You know, there's only more vibrance and more contrast on the Xiaomi 13 Pro. Honestly, I think the contrast is a bit too much. Some of the shadows seem to be getting crushed a little too much, in my opinion. Usually I like high contrast, but this time I think the X80 is doing a slightly better job. And it's also really playing to my taste personally, because the greens, it looks so realistic on the X80 that it looks perfect to me. But anyways, let's take a look at zoom. So here we have 2x zoom on both. And yes, the X80 doesn't really have as high contrast as the Xiaomi. My personal preference does go to the Xiaomi, but the quality of the shot is better on the X80. It is optical zoom that we're getting on the X80. So naturally, 2x zoom is gonna be better on the X80. At 3x, however, of course, the Xiaomi takes ahead. It's got optical zoom and it's very high quality, by the way. The 3x on the Xiaomi 30 Pro, one of the best 3x optical zoom cameras that you can get on the market right now. Then at 5x, now the Vivo X80 Pro does take a lead because it has a 5x periscope zoom, but there are a lot of issues with that. First and foremost, zero contrast. I mean, it's so flat, it looks like the lock profile that you get out of normal professional cameras. and well, the quality of the camera isn't that good. It's an 8 megapixel sensor, very low quality considering the standards that we have in this day and age. It's not nearly as good. Very similar story at 10x. I mean, it's a pretty obvious thing here, and the contrast did improve a little bit on the X80 Pro. I do like how the X80 looks here at 10x quite a bit. Actually, I prefer it far more than the 5x shot that we had at 20x. Well, I don't think either of these look very nice, because the X80 is, once again, the lower quality sensor, it drops off very easily. And so 10x would be the sweet spot if you want to get a good quality image. On the Xiaomi, of course, you don't really have long range zoom options. But we do get sort of a macro mode on the Xiaomi 13 Pro. Now, the reason I say sort of is because the macro mode isn't very good. You can't really get very close with it. Now, the X80 Pro, it's actually pretty good with this macro, as you can see. Really nice with the close-ups. But the Xiaomi 13 Pro does have something called a super macro mode. Now, you have to toggle it on every single time you want to use it. It doesn't naturally turn on. Then you're actually using the 3x periscope zoom to take a macro shot. I've never seen that done before, and it does give you a ton of bokeh in the background. I mean, the depth of field is insane with the super macro mode on the Xiaomi 13 Pro, and yes, it does get closer as opposed to the normal macro mode on the Xiaomi 13 Pro. Now, in this case, it's pretty obvious that yes, the X80 Pro looks far better with the colors and the contrast, but the closeness to the subject, yeah, you get really close with the Xiaomi 13 Pro's super macro. But now let's move on to high resolution. So you have 50 megapixels with the main camera on both phones. And in this case, I like the image on the Xiaomi 13 Pro a little bit more, because with the X80, you can see it's very saturated. That's because you cannot use Zeiss Natural Colors when you're using high res. But what really blew my mind is that the X80 Pro somehow managed to get more detail in this shot as opposed to the Xiaomi 13 Pro. This 500% crop, and the X80 Pro looks significantly better. I mean, this is quite something. I even checked to make sure that we have the right images. We do. The X80 Pro indeed has more detail. Now, I have two theories for this. Either the Xiaomi 13 Pro just diabolically screwed up here and it just captured no detail, or the X80 Pro, amongst the few updates that it had in the few months, it actually had a patch to improve the detail levels with high res. But anyways, let's now check out high res with the ultra wide camera. Now, I remember distinctly, very clearly, that the X80 Pro did not have particularly good high res with the ultra wide camera. But when we zoomed in, once again 500%, and the difference isn't really all that much. Now, the Xiaomi 13 Pro's ultra wide high res is actually quite good. Compared it to the OnePlus 11, it was better than the OnePlus 11. So in general, I expected the Xiaomi 13 Pro to really pull ahead, but you know, I'm not seeing a ton of difference. Yeah, maybe, you know, this, in some places I see a little bit more over sharpening happening on the X80, but it's minor as opposed to the massive expectation that I had. But of course, with the 3x, I think Xiaomi is like one of the very few people who actually give us high res with zoom. So that's actually quite nice, because as you can see, obviously the X80 is not going to do that well because it doesn't really have the high res, nor does it have the 3x optical. But the detail preservation on the Xiaomi 13 Pro with high res, it's really good even with the telephoto camera. But with that said, now let's talk about human subjects. So right here we have a very difficult selfie, needless to say. It's not a cakewalk. Even the X80 Pro is blowing out some highlights, and that just does not happen almost ever. And well, as difficult as the shot was, I'm really impressed by how well Xiaomi managed to nail it, because as you can see, it has more detail, it has better skin tones, and yeah, it's blowing out the highlight in the background a touch more, but it's nailing my colors and my skin tone, so you know, I prefer the Xiaomi here. But moving on to this one, now it's a polar opposite, because yeah, this is also slightly backlit. But the thing about the previous shot was that there was a light that was directly hitting my face. It wasn't as bright as the daylight in the background, but there was some light. In this case, the light hitting my face was not really all that much. So I think that really affects the quality of the selfie you're gonna get out of the Xiaomi 13 Pro. The X80 Pro is actually doing a really good job with the details. You can see so much more texture on my shirt as opposed to the Xiaomi 13 Pro. And I also really like the colors on the X80 here. As you can see, the Xiaomi is really struggling. This time, once again, I did not have a lot of light just falling on my face. Most of the light was in the background. So, as you can see, the X80 is coping up with that disadvantage much more than the Xiaomi 13 Pro. So that's definitely something to keep in mind. As for selfie portraits, well, this is a very simple one, you know, there's daylight falling on my face, so neither phone is gonna screw up. And actually, the Vivo X80 Pro has a little bit more detail, but it also has a few screw-ups happening right around my face. You can see some of the bokeh and the edge detection, it's just not working out quite as well as the Xiaomi 13 Pro. Now here's a backlit shot, and yes, I did have plenty of light falling on my face this time. As you can see, the Xiaomi 13 Pro is doing a fantastic job. It has an absolute boatload of details as opposed to the X80 Pro. It has really nice contrast and colors, and yes, once again, it is blowing out the highlight in the background a touch more, but eyes the subject just look better on the Xiaomi 13 Pro here. As for this one, I would quite easily say that this is a pretty ridiculous selfie portrait right here. The Xiaomi 13 Pro, it has a little bit more detail, but it's completely blowing out the highlights. I mean, you can't even tell that there's a chandelier back there. It looks like the entire ceiling's on fire. While the X80 Pro is doing a far better job with the dynamic range, but the details, you can see the textures on my shirt, is basically non-existent. And the skin tones don't really look very appealing now, do they? As for night mode selfies, guess what? Both phones have them, and neither of them are particularly good at it. Now look, maybe I took the selfie in a particularly dark situation, but you know, you'll see soon enough. I took a night portrait with a rear camera, and both of them did a far better job than they did with the selfie camera. So yeah, needless to say, neither phone is going to exactly blow your mind when it comes to night selfies. As well, let's move on to rear camera portraits. Now, in this case, I actually prefer the X80 Pro. I mean, the Xiaomi looks good, it looks really nice, but I just prefer the slightly more saturated looking skin tones. It looks a little bit more accurate, and the contrast just looks a touch more balanced. It looks a bit too dark in the shadows on the Xiaomi 13 Pro, for my taste at least. Now this, yeah, needless to say, this was not easy, and even though it doesn't look like it, the Xiaomi 13 Pro is completely messing up the white balance, because the X80 Pro, that's how it looked when we took the shot. That's accurate. That's exactly the white balance we had, because it was during sunset and you can see the gradient in the background. So the, you know, this is exactly how it looked. And massive props to the X80 Pro for maintaining that level of white balance given the insane situation. Now yes, the X80 Pro looks a bit more processed, sure, as opposed to the Xiaomi 13 Pro, but you know, overall, I personally think it's doing a much better job. Because to be honest, if I'm gonna take a shot at sunset, I would like it to look like sunset. But anyways, let's move on to zoomed in portraits. Now, I do think that in general, both of them are just gonna do insanely well. As you can see, both look really nice, very well detailed. I like the contrast of the Xiaomi a touch more, but it's a very minor difference. In a nutshell, you're not gonna have any real issues with zoomed in portraits. As for a backlit shot, with zoomed in portrait, well, in this case, I like a lot of things about the X80 Pro, like the bokeh in the background looks absolutely beautiful. The skin tones, I think they look a little bit more natural. There's a bit more texture happening on my face. The details on my face look a little bit sharper. But the darker blacks on the Xiaomi 13 Pro, big fan of that as well. So I'm really torn on this. But I guess if I really think about everything, I kind of lean towards the X80 Pro here. As for night mode portraits, well, once again, a lot of back and forth. So the X80 Pro, we have, once again, better bokeh and better background blur. The night mode portraits on the Xiaomi 13 Pro, they tend to suffer a little with the background blur, because as you can see, it's not really happening a lot and it's kind of inconsistent really. While the X80 Pro, it's definitely warming up the image a lot. The skin tones look nice on the X80, while the Xiaomi, it looks too yellow. The blacks look better on the Xiaomi, while the X80, it looks really brown. So yeah, there's a lot of things to consider in this case. So overall, I kind of prefer the Xiaomi a little because of the skin tones and the slightly high details. But anyways, let's now move on to night mode. And this is where things are gonna get fairly interesting. So one thing that was so weird and awkward, just it blew my mind. So in previous camera comparison, every single photography comparison I've done thus far with the Xiaomi 13 Pro, it managed to nail focusing on close-ups at night, like easily. I didn't have any trouble whatsoever. In this case, God knows why, I changed the angle, I changed the distance between the subject, I changed the subject itself just to see what was going on, but no dice. The Xiaomi 13 Pro just would not focus on those damn flowers or any of the other flowers around it. I don't know what the issue was, but yeah, I just stood there for like 5 minutes straight getting bitten by mosquitoes and just trying to take that damn image, and then I just gave up. The X80 Pro had zero problems, just to be completely honest. And yes, the X80 Pro looks more natural. That was the kind of warm streetlights that we had on the subject and in the scene. So just saying, that's how it should have looked. The Xiaomi 13 Pro didn't even nail the white balance here, much less focusing. But anyways, I didn't even talk about the whole Leica Authentic and Vibrant situation. So at night, you want to use Leica Authentic. That's right, during the daytime, not a good idea. But at night, you actually get really natural night mode shots. Like in this case, as you can see, far more contrast, sky looks super realistic, and it looks really nice on the Xiaomi 13 Pro with Leica Authentic. The X80 Pro also looks really nice, but that blue sky, not the biggest fan of it. Now in this case, I'm using Leica Vibrant, and as you can see, it's very close to the X80 Pro, slightly bluish sky and overall contrast is lower. A lot of details, yes, a lot of vibrance, as you'd expect, but when I switched to the Leica Authentic, I mean, it's more than obvious that the Leica Authentic, it looks like nighttime. This looks like a night shot, if I've ever seen one. And personally, that speaks to me. That high contrast, really dark night sky, it looks so natural, it looks right. To my eyes at least. But anyways, let's move on. Now right here we have 2x on the X80 Pro and 3x on the Xiaomi 13 Pro. These are the respective telephoto zooms that you get. And yes, both of them look really nice here. We do have a fair bit of light, and when we do, as you would expect, you can get really nice and highly detailed night mode shots from both. Now the white balance is a bit off on both, if I'm being entirely honest. The X80 cooled it off a little too much. The Xiaomi 13 Pro warmed it up a bit too much. Neither of them look perfectly accurate here. Now you can take 5x shots as well, but it's mostly going to be digital. As you can see, it doesn't really look very nice. That's because the sensor quality is just not there with the 5x periscope, so you're just gonna get cropped in images anyways. Now for ultrawide cameras, well, interestingly, the Xiaomi 13 Pro once again warmed it up, man. This is intense warming right here. It almost looks like there's a nuclear explosion happening like a foot behind me. Not a fan of that. The X80, it's not quite as warm as I would have personally liked it to be 100% realistic, but it looks far better, far more balanced as opposed to the Xiaomi 13 Pro. Although I do like the contrast on the Xiaomi. Now this one was very dark, to say the very least. And the Xiaomi 13 Pro, it kind of conveys that same darkness. You know, you can get the darkness in the sky, you get the darkness in the shadows. And personally, I really like the look of that. It really just makes the image pop in a very subtle manner, if that makes any sense. The X80 Pro, it's like a very safe image. You get all the details in the shadows, you get, you know, conserved highlights, you get detail in the sky. I mean, if you don't mind slightly flatter looking images, and if you want the look of the image on the X80, then yeah, it's gonna be really nice. And well, that's the end of our camera comparison. I must say, this was way closer than I expected it to be. It's a massive compliment for the X80 Pro in general, because it's from last year. There are not a lot of phones from last year that can really stack up and compete against some of the best flagships that we have around. Xiaomi 13 Pro, it has its issues. It has that massive problem with the lack of vibrant and the lack of authentic daytime images with the HDR processing and all that, but it's well-rounded enough with certain issues that could really use some resolving right now. So with that said, I do hope you guys enjoyed, found this helpful, and I'll be seeing you guys soon enough with a few more videos to come. Cheers!